Acquitted. The water.
I keep giving you segues without even knowing.
You know, you butt it.
You knock
it
down.
I don't play tennis, so I don't know how that works.
I actually thought it was a baseball term, actually.
Or baseball. I don't sports. You know, just generally. This is Acquitted. This was originally aired in 2015 in its native Norway. Stars.
Please do it.
Nikolai Cleve Rosh.
The
very same. Who, when we first meet him, is a successful businessman working for a big corporation in Kuala Lumpur in Malaysia.
Why did you struggle more with Kuala Lumpur than you did with Nikolai?
Because I was doing it, if you remember, in that episode of The Simpsons when Bumblebee Man did it.
True. I want you to say every country name as the Bumblebee Man from The Simpsons from now on, if you could.
Did you notice who his wife was?
Yes, but now I looked her up and now I can't remember.
Elaine Tan, who played Lee in EastEnders back in the mid-2000s.
She went out with Mickey.
Was growing cannabis in Gus's flat.
That's her.
Basically, he gets a phone call from someone who we later learn is from his hometown. Saying that there's a business, a solar business that he owns with his family that's struggling, and that he wants Axel to basically convince his business associates to invest in. Yeah. We don't know what the sort of problem is there, really, to start off with. So he basically, along with some of his colleagues, journeys back to, it's basically his native village, and soon enough we learn that the couple who own the energy company had a daughter who died, and Axel was charged with the murder. It was something to do with he was accused of hitting her against the head with a rock several times, okay. I remember.
Hitting her head against a rock, not hitting her against her head with a rock. Yeah, I just translated that from Northern. That's what I did.
That bombshell drops about halfway through, doesn't it, about him being acquitted of the crime. He goes, he sees people working in the energy business and things like that. And
there are some people who he knows who work with them.
He goes to visit his mother, and there's a very strange scene with his mother where she doesn't let him.
I like that scene, though. It was bizarre, but I quite liked it.
Yeah, and basically, I loved how this ended as well. He'd agreed to invest in the company, but Eva didn't want him to because of his past, because of their relationship. And he basically threatened her, didn't he? Because he thinks that if the energy company doesn't get saved, then it'll basically be it for the town, for the village.
He's sort of saying, look, don't use this again as another excuse to stop the town moving forward.
And I liked how sort of silent it was, like all basically every member of the board started to get up apart from the husband, who stayed seated at the end, and that's how it ended. That was for me the perfect cliffhanger. There wasn't any sort of big explosions or anything like that.
We talked about it before. It's a show I've come to love, and it's now finished, and I've seen all the series of it, but Rectify, there's definite parallels with, in fact it's pretty much the similar plot with, except Rectify, he was in prison for life in solitary confinement for so many years, and he's let out. And
we don't know. The thing is, here we don't know the intricacies of what happened, how long he was in jail, and things.
And
I have
to admit, I didn't like this at first. It wasn't one of the things that
no, really.
I didn't like it at first. It took
is it just because everyone in it was so attractive?
No, that's usually a plus point. No, I didn't like it at first. It took me a while. I was more into, as soon as he got off the helicopter and met up with
It got back to Norway.
When he got to Norway and when he did what he was supposed to do and when the story could start, I was quite invested. It wasn't like last week when we talked about Case, where I was watching it through a screen. I was involved. I was invested. I cared about the outcome.
Do you think part of that is because it's not formulaic, it's about a character, it's not about a police officer or a doctor or something like that? It's about this character, it's about, redemption.
It's about the character, it's about the people who he's affected, moving on or trying to move on. It's about going back to somewhere where you don't feel you belong it's not anymore. Your, but
I think it's not your typical naughty drama, is it? I don't feel like...
I've not seen one like this. No.
And there's a lot of English in it, which is a plus.
It is a plus. Gotta check my email during that bit. Do you think if this was on BBC 4, you'd be watching this? Or doesn't it matter? Would you watch it?
I'm definitely going to watch the second episode. I'm definitely going to do that. But
yeah.
I think it would give me more incentive if it was if there was more of a structure to it.
Yeah, I think it's the garage thing.
It's like it's not going anywhere. I can rest it and.
I never believe that when he said. Well, obviously he does, but that doesn't work for me. I'd much rather have that structure that we're used to. Perhaps it's Well, it is old-fashioned now, clearly. But if I have to go and seek out this, I don't know whether... Because as much as I enjoy it, and I might remember it when I piece the podcast together, am I going to remember it in 2 weeks' time when I'm watching other stuff? I don't know. But that's only because it's not on the telly and I have to go and seek it out. I don't know. What's your opinion on it?
I don't know, because I don't watch much on the TV, but I like having that structure where there's like one episode a week or two episodes a week, and I know that they're there. Saying that, though, I mean, I fell behind with all of the naughty dramas, really. So
I think you do have to be in a mood for it, because you do have to concentrate
not
far
in a mood.
More.
Like, you just, like, you have
no,
to
you
be...
No, you have to be pissed off at the world to watch us go... No, you have to be in the mood for it. You can't just stick one on and do the housework or... You know, not that you should during any drama. You should be watching it. But yeah, I know what you mean. Far better than Case, I would highly definitely. Recommend.
I found this to be such an easy watch.
It was almost relaxed. I know I just said you need to concentrate, but I almost found it quite relaxing.
It was all those, I think it was the Norwegian fjords that did it.